Welcome to Cloudyn's short how-to videos. In this video, we're going to look at an actual cost analysis broken out over time. This is what you might think of in terms of a trend analysis, the ability to analyze your spend and find anomalies in those particular days. So let's go there under cost, cost analysis, actual cost over time. This will break out our spending by days by default, but we can change our resolution to weeks, months, quarters, years, and as before, we can also change our date range to any of the options in here. So let's take a look at our spend for the last, the previous month, broken out by day. Now I'm gonna clear this out so we can start fresh with a clean report. And one of the common things that we will want to do in a multi-cloud environment is be able to see our analysis across multiple providers. So as always, Cloudyn brings multiple providers' data together into one holistic view for your world. And we'll clear out all of our filters so that we can see exactly what's going on here. All right, so now, now you can see our true spend analysis over time. Again, we're looking at the previous month, or the month of August 2017. And as you can see, we had a pretty hefty uptick on the 15th of August that tapered back down to a steady run rate, and then another tick up at the end of August. Now we might want to be able to understand exactly where those dollars are going. So let's start by adding our provider filter in here. So this is going to break out our spend by Azure, AWS, and Google. And as you can see, the majority of my spend is in AWS with a steady run rate of Azure. So let's take a little bit deeper look at why our AWS spend jumped up. So the first thing we'll do is we'll filter down to just AWS, and then we'll add our service types on top of there. So now we've filtered down to just AWS, and let's add service, and we can see exactly what service offering it was that caused our spike in utilization. So the first spike in utilization was in Elastic Block Storage, or EBS. So we could further drill in and find out exactly what resource types or operations actually occurred inside of there. But our second type, if we hover over that, is a big jump in our EC2 spend. So this is most likely either a substantial uptick in the utilization on our virtual machines, or potentially some purchases of reservations. If we wanted to analyze that a little bit further, we could drill in on those particular days, or we could extend this for the last 30 days. So let's take a look at that. Let's go look at the last 30 days of spend and see if this trend continues over time. It doesn't. See, it drops back off over after the weekend. So let's take a little closer look and see exactly what happened here. So let's filter down to EC2. And then once we've got that filtration in, I'm going to take a look at cost type. And this will tell us if this was an on-demand utilization rate or if this was a one-time fee. And all of the spend was based on usage. So now we can understand exactly that we didn't purchase any reservations. This was all usage-based costs. So the next thing we want to understand is who's responsible. So we can add our account name in here, and this will give us a breakdown of which accounts are responsible for that big spike in spend. And it turns out that we are looking at our demo enterprise. Now there are two different policies down here in the extended filter. Consolidated policy shows all of the utilization rolled up to the top level, or in AWS terms, the consolidated payer, or in Azure terms, to the EA itself. The standalone policy allows us to see the breakdown of the individual accounts and subscriptions underneath that top level entry. Now it turns out that this particular jump in spend happened to be rolled up in our top level account in that demo enterprise. So at this point I could go to the owner of the demo enterprise account and understand exactly what happened. But I have better understanding right now of where my dollars have gone and the anomalies in that spend.